Jen, and I'm an educator at the Ontario Science Centre, but today I'm going to be talking to you about the nature of science from my home. Understanding the nature of science is not only important in the classroom or laboratory, but also in your home, because it helps us make better decisions about scientific issues that affect our daily lives. Things like, do I need to wear a mask to go to the grocery store during a pandemic? So, what is science? We use the word science all the time, but we don't always think about what science really is. Today, we're going to unpack the word science. We'll look at how science knowledge is constructed, how science reflects our worldviews, and why it really matters who does science. At its very core, science is a way of thinking. It's a process we use to try and solve problems and understand the world through a critical lens that's shaped by our perspectives. Let's practice our scientific thinking right now with this mystery tube. The world is kind of like this tube. We're trying to understand how it works, even if we can't always see what's happening directly. Instead, we have to collect observations and then make inferences based on those observations to help us build a model. Scientists do this all the time. Now you can see that there's four strings sticking out of my tube. Let's practice your observation skills. As I pull the different strings, I want you to observe and record what you see. Were there any unexpected observations when you were watching the tube? Now, I want you to start thinking about what is happening inside of this tube. We call this a scientific model. It's a hypothesis about how something works based on our observations. When I pull the yellow rope, why do the other ropes get shorter? You can't know for sure without opening this tube up, but you can make an inference or an educated guess. So I want you to pause the video right now and start drawing a model of what you think is inside the tube based on all of your observations. The best models usually require collaboration between scientists. So I want you to show this video and the drawing that you made to a member of your household and ask them for feedback. Scientists ask for feedback from their peers all the time. Different perspectives and experience matter, and collective knowledge is always more powerful. So feel free to update your model after talking with someone else. Like any good scientist, once you've come up with a model, you have to test it. I want you to build the tube the way you've drawn it and use it to test your model. Start by making a prediction. If I think two strings are connected, then pulling one string should make the other move. Is that what happens when you try it? If your prediction is wrong, it means you have to update your model. But here's the catch. If your prediction works out, that doesn't necessarily mean your model is correct. It just means it could be right. You have to keep making predictions, keep testing it, and keep making changes to the model whenever it fails. Of course, you're probably thinking right now, Jen, why can't you just rip up your tube and show us what's inside? And you're right, in this case, I could. I could rip it up and show you, but I won't, because that's not how science works. In the world of science, there's often no way to see exactly what's going on. Things might be too small, like electrons, or too far away, like black holes, or too complex, like predicting the weather. And yet, scientific models allow us to study every one of those things. Next, my colleague Anne is going to give you another chance to practice your model building skills by having you make some observations and inferences in a different context.
Thanks, Jen. Hello, everyone. I'm Anne. Like Jen, I too am an educator at the Ontario Science Centre, working from home, for now. In this activity, you will use the skills of observation, inference, and scientific model building that you practiced with Jen and the mystery box to interpret a set of fossils. Let's get started. Here you can see a drawing of a set of fossil footprints found in a rock bed in North America. I'd like you to observe the footprints, make some inferences about those footprints, and then develop a model of what you think happened to create those footprints. In developing your model, you want to consider what type of organisms made these footprints, how many were there, what was their size, what was their speed and direction? Pause the recording and make your observations and inferences, and then develop your model. You now have a model to explain what you saw. How confident are you that your model describes what actually happened? Would more information help you refine your model? Here's more of the fossils' footprints. How does your model change with this additional information? Does it support your existing model, or do you need to change your model entirely? Pause the recording and revise or redevelop your previous model. With more information, I'm sure your model changed from the original, but we're not done yet. Let's add a little more information. Interesting. Does this change your model? Pause the recording and revise or redevelop your model once more. Take a minute to consider how your model changed each time you were provided with new information. What part of your model are you absolutely sure about? What part of your model are you unsure about? Keeping your model in mind, let's see what others came up with.
Red animal came in, saw some plants because it was a herbivore, and then ran and started eating the plants. And then the green animal, which is a carnivore, walked in a bit and then saw the red animal and then ran in, and then they got into a fight, and then the green animal ate the red animal, and then the green animal walked away.
They appear to be converging or walking towards a point on the right-hand side of the photograph. What's not clear to me is the timing of the footprints were made. They could have been made either simultaneously, or one could have been made at a different point in time. And I also wasn't quite sure about the orientation of the image when I first looked at it, so I flipped it upside down and they no longer look like footprints to me. They actually look like jellyfish, two sets of jellyfish swimming in the opposite direction from each other.
Like, let's say it's a butterfly. Mm-hmm. They come, let's say, those monarchs from Mexico, and they lay eggs on the milkweed. Mm-hmm. Then become they worm like.
The caterpillar.
And then they caterpillar. Then it's a pupa, and then creates wings again.
Yeah. Oh, maybe. So you think it was eggs that might have been laid there, and then when they matured, they walked away.
They can walk away. How you go know the right answer? How?
Sometimes there isn't a right answer, Dad. Mm-hmm. I find it fascinating that you all looked at the same pictures and yet you created different models. To use scientific terminology, the pictures were evidence or data. What you saw in the pictures and chose to focus on were your observations. Inferences are the conclusions you reach based on your observations, your prior knowledge, and your reasoning. And the model is what you developed to explain all the observations and inferences and predict what might happen next. The footprints activity highlights two important aspects of scientific knowledge construction. First, that science changes with new information, and second, perspective matters in science. Your model changed as you were provided with more information. This is what happens in science. New evidence leads to updating models and sometimes coming up with entirely new models. Is your model the right one? In this case, and often in science, there is no real way of knowing. As we get more information, our models change. That's what makes science so exciting. It's important to reflect on why each person's model was slightly different. The models you build are based on your lived experiences, how you construct knowledge, and your perspectives of the world. Others have different experiences and so interpret the fossils differently. For example, paleontologists who have more experience and knowledge of fossils would interpret the pictures we saw today differently than you and I would. Although perspective is important, so is a knowledge base. Scientific thinking must be supported by knowledge. That's why it's important to develop both your scientific knowledge and your scientific thinking skills. Understanding how to use observation and inferences to build models, and knowing that science changes with new evidence and that perspective matters in science, will help you better understand science and society and things like the COVID-19 pandemic. Jen's going to show you what we mean.
Thanks, Anne. Scientific models are all around us, but they're in the news now more than ever. During the COVID-19 pandemic, you may have noticed that advice based on scientific models changes week to week. Don't wear a mask. You should wear a mask. Maybe you can be reinfected. People aren't actually being reinfected. What is the answer? How is the disease spread? How should you protect yourself? Just like the mystery tube and footprints, scientists don't have all the information they need to know definitively what is happening. You're seeing the scientific process happen in real time. Every day, new discoveries are made that change the model, change the way scientists understand COVID-19. Science is tentative, not wrong, but tentative, always changing as new information arises. Just like you may have changed your model when Anne uncovered new fossils, these models are also being constantly updated in light of new information. Unfortunately, the novel coronavirus has impacted people around the world, but it has also spurred worldwide scientific collaboration. Just like with the mystery tube and footprints, each person adds something different and important to our understanding. Institutions in China and Australia have collaborated to publish the coronavirus genome sequence on an open access site, which means that it's free for scientists everywhere to use. We're also seeing rapid advances in vaccine research, with 133 different vaccines across the world in development from Thailand to Canada. Looking at this map can be misleading. It might appear that countries in the African continent are not contributing to the fight against COVID-19. Although they may not be involved in vaccine research right now, they have made large contributions in testing techniques, disease containment strategies, and medical interventions to help treat the disease. This is in addition to all the other medical research happening on this continent every day. As scientists, and more importantly, as members of society, we need to be critical of what we see and hear. Every country is contributing in their own way and with their own expertise. The power here is that we're getting lots of different perspectives working together.
Today we saw that science is a process of collecting observations, making inferences, and building models. In the mystery box and footprints activity, you saw that models change in light of new information. Science is tentative. And that different people can create different models from the same data. Perspective matters in science. We live in a unique period of time where the whole world is relying on science to understand and fight a pandemic, COVID-19. Understanding the nature of how scientific knowledge is constructed, how we know what we know, can help you understand what you read, hear, and see in the news, on social media, and when talking to others. Like no time before, it is important to be critical of the information you read, hear, and believe. Whose voice is being heard? Whose voice is missing from the conversation, and why? Our lived experiences influence our perspectives of the world, and so truly good science ensures that all voices, regardless of race, gender, and class, are valued and heard without prejudice. It's important to gather other people's perspectives and practice scientific thinking. Try showing the fossil pictures to someone you know and see what they think, or test the mystery tube you built on your family and friends. As you experience and explore the world, remember to use your skills of scientific thinking to be critical of the issues around you. Never hesitate to ask, test, repeat.